daughters of Artemis are strong here. I'll be on my guard.
Thank you. What do you need? Good day to you. that noise?
What's that? I don't think I imagined it. Huh? What's that noise?
Athenians will have trouble maintaining control now.
Your head?
Ah!
Let's go!
Thank you.
Thank you. I will follow the most to the underworld and bring my hordes with us.
Thank you.
need to find who's doing that. What? Oh.
Time for a ride. They say you can't walk this battlefield without getting blood on your toes.
If you close your eyes, you can hear them. Their final war cries. Before every last one of those brave Spartans perished. Their voices were silenced that day, but their story will be sung for an eternity.
You didn't bring me here to talk about dead Spartans. What's on your mind, Hirovatos?
The Battle of Thermopylae still echoes in our hearts. But to stand here is to feel it in your bones.
There's nothing here but ghosts. My concerns are with the living.
Hold out your spear.
My spear? What for?
I need to know something.
Hirovatos!
I'm fine. The stories are true. That is the spear of Leonidas. The hero's blade.
What happened to the traitor, Ephialtes?
King Xerxes paid him well. But treachery breeds treachery. A contract was put on his head, and he died as he lived. A coward.
What happened to Leonidas after the battle?
Xerxes was famous for honoring warriors who fought valiantly against the Persians. But Leonidas infuriated him so much, he cut off his head and impaled it on a pike. A bloody battle ensued, and his remains were reclaimed by the Spartans and buried here. Now, however, he rests where he belongs.
In Sparta. Where were Sparta's allies?
The Spartans weren't alone in facing Xerxes and his hordes. Many from across the Greek world were armed and ready to fight alongside Leonidas and his 300. But when the mighty king looked into their eyes and saw fear, he sent them home.
That sounds like madness, not bravery.
It was foretold by the Pythia that Sparta would lose either its freedom or its king to the Persians. Leonidas made his choice.
You knew this would happen.
I didn't know, but I did suspect. There is a place I convinced myself was a dream. Until now. A peculiar structure on the island of Andros. Mysterious shapes carved in stone. Like nothing I've ever seen.
You want to sail to Andros so you can show me shapes?
In my travels, I heard whispers of an ancient civilization. A people who came before. Your spear and that place are connected.
You mentioned a people that came before. Who were they?
They were not gods, but they lived far longer than any mortal, and were far more intelligent. I've seen carvings in caves, strange symbols that suggest it was this ancient civilization that created humankind and provided them with fire.
But Zeus blamed Prometheus.
Yes. Well, perhaps his eagle has been feasting on the wrong liver.
The spear awakened to you, Herodotus. I trust you.
You understand. I will do everything in my power to help you find your mother. I promise. But first, we must sail to the island of Andros.
I'll meet you at my ship.
Welcome aboard the Adrestia, Herodotus! You be traveling with us?
Only for a short trip. I have business to attend to.
Herodotus is helping me find my mother.
Seeking help from the gods has put Herodotus on your path, just like they put you on mine. They work in ways beyond our comprehension, and all we can do is follow their lead.
You could be right. Herodotus and I share enemies too.
Like Elpinor?
He is... was... part of a very powerful group called the Cult of Cosmos, that controls the Greek world through the Oracle.
Control the Oracle? Impossible! Apollo would not allow that!
Now they're looking for my mother. I need to find her before they do.
And I believe they will hurt others who oppose their views along the way.
By Hermes! The Oracle lost to corruption, and now this cult? Do we know who leads them?
I don't know for sure, but... I think it might be my brother.
Your brother? By Zeus, your life is complicated!
Tell me about it.
But don't you worry! This cult of Cosmos now has three new enemies! And one of them fights like Athena, and shits thunder like Zeus! We'll bring the wrath of the gods down upon them!
Is he always this positive?
Always. That's why I like him.
Poseidon, carry us to Athens!
First, we need to go to Andros.
To Andros, then! We're going to have to do some upgrades to my ship if we're sailing into war.
What do you mean?
Well, she's old, and perhaps not in the best condition.
You couldn't have said this before we set sail? Where in Poseidon's name are we going to get the supplies?
My father taught me that the sea takes, and we must do the same. Fortunately, there are plenty of pirate ships in these waters that we can board and take from.
What are we waiting for? Let's hunt some pirates!
Now that we have the necessary resources, we can upgrade the ship's hull.
Thank you.
Commander.
Check your oars!
We've spotted some salvage!
Oars down!
Let's hope no one notices me here.
Thank you. How'd they get here? Let's take a look.
Down the Spartan conquest.
Thank you. quickly!
To be a mercenary's work.
Is someone whistling? Signaling for help!
What the?
I guess I'll go look then.
Thank you.
Are these people harassing you?
Harassing him? We're his parents!
I told you, Mother. This is for your protection.
Protection from what, exactly?
He just got back from Delphi. Spoke with the Oracle. Been out of his mind ever since.
She revealed my prophecy. My mind has never been more clear. She said I would do unspeakable things to my parents. That Mother's blood would stain the earth. And Potter would scream to the gods in agony.
Oracles and prophecies do more harm than good. You should listen to your gut. What are you doing?
Listening to my gut. And it's telling me my parents will suffer if you don't help me.
Here we go.
You could save my parents from my vicious wrath.
You don't have a vicious bone in your body.
Quiet, Pater. Me and the Missios are talking. My sword and shield. Gifts from Mater and Pater. We must return them to my parents, so they can defend themselves from my ferocious temper.
All right, Subidio. I'll get these weapons for you. For a price.
Of course! My parents will gladly pay you for your troubles.
What?
What?
Seek out Costa, the village blacksmith. I brought him the sword to be sharpened not too long ago.
And the shield?
This will be trickier. I'll explain when you return from the blacksmith.
Can't wait.
You are being superstitious!
You mustn't free me. These ropes are the only thing my parents want.
Myself. Prophet on Earth. My name is Costa, at your service.
Cassandra.
Whatever you need, name it. It's yours. I could bend some metal for you, oil those rippling muscles, fix that broken spear.
I'm looking for a sword. Belongs to Supidio.
Ah, Supidio. Love that boy. Bit on the thin side, if you ask me. His parents feed him nothing.
Yes. Well. He needs his sword back.
And I'd love to give it to you. His sword, I mean. But I can't just hand over swords to every gorgeous warrior who walks by.
Give me the sword, and I'll make this a day you'll never forget.
Oh, that would make every dream I've ever had come true. There's just one tiny problem. You see, my spear is also broken, if you catch my meaning.
Shame.
But there are special flowers in the forest beyond Xerxes' military fort, planted by Aphrodite herself. They really help to, reforge, if you know what I mean.
Fine. I'll get the flowers, and you'll give me the spear. I mean, sword. I mean, don't go anywhere. That should be enough to stoke the blacksmith's flame.
juice, Mistios. You take my breath away. Did you bring the flowers?
I can't even go flower picking without some beast trying to kill me. But yes, I have them.
Perfect! So, did you mean what you said about making this a day I'd never forget?
Enough talking. Eat your plants.
That was incredible.
Thank Aphrodite.
Thank all the gods. Here, as promised, I'll never forget you.
No, you won't. I should get this back to Stupidio's parents before he does anything Stupidio.
Mistios, you've returned. Did you bring the sword?
I did.
Thank the gods. I knew I could count on you. But this is only one of the items I needed. And I have two parents.
So tell me about this shield.
Well, according to my parents, it was stolen while I was visiting the Oracle of Delphi.
Stolen? It's as good as gone, then.
I overheard Mater and Pater whispering about it. They mentioned the cave beyond the Red Lake. Talked about the thief as if they knew her.
Strange.
Go to the cave, Mistios. Bring me back my shield. Only then will my parents be truly safe from my fury. Mistios! At last! Did you find the shield?
I did. Now, you can protect yourselves from the prophecy.
So, you found the thief?
Oh yes. Cut her in half. She won't steal anything from anyone ever again.
And what about the blacksmith?
Oh, he's very much alive.
We did things in the back of his workshop that would make Aphrodite blush.
You didn't!
This is awful!
Mater? Pater, what's wrong? You're safe. The prophecy's broken.
Actually, there's something we've been meaning to tell you. Stupidio, you were adopted.
What?
A young couple brought you to us. They knew we'd give you a better home. That sword and shield is your inheritance from them.
Wait. So the thief and the blacksmith
are Stupidio's birth parents. You killed his mater and fucked his pater.
But the prophecy said Pater would scream to the gods in agony.
Oh, he screamed, but not in agony.
You killed Mater and had sex with Pater!
Stupidio, I had no idea.
I can't get the image out of my head. I don't want to see anymore. I'm blind, Mistios. Are you happy? My dreams are forever haunted. Mother will bleed, Pater will scream.
Lokris, land of salt and more salt.
ship.
What?
Who's back?
When deciding where our loyalties lie, we must consider the end.
They're leaving the helm!